As baseball fans, we are constantly putting players into specific categories or giving them certain labels based on what they did in their career. There's players who, whether you like them or not, are just too good to be ignored, who we call generational talents, stars, or faces of the franchise. Then there's players who are a step higher, who will go down as the greatest to ever play. We refer to them as GOATs, legends, and all-timers. Lastly, there's the complete opposite end of the spectrum, guys who looked like they were going down the same path, but didn't live up to their full potential, or maybe suffered an injury that derailed the future of their careers. These are guys that we label as overrated, overpaid, or washed up. For the most part, over a certain period of time, we're able to decipher which players belong in which category, but once in a while we get a player in the gray area of these categories and labels, a guy who belongs to all of them and none of them at the same time. Guys like Stephen Strasburg. Depending on who you ask and what year you ask them, you'll get a ton of different opinions on the type of player he was. He's a pitcher who's seen the highest of highs, the lowest of lows, and somewhere in the middle. We're going to break down this fascinating career from a man who has literally been through it all, and answer the question, how will he be remembered? Before I get into it, welcome to the War Room. I'm going to be making MLB content like this all season long, so subscribe to the channel if you're new, and let's get straight to it. On July 20th, 1988, Stephen James Strasburg was born in San Diego, California. Similar to most future major leaguers, growing up, he had a deep love for baseball and consistently stood out as the top pitcher on his teams. He attended West Hills High School in Santee, California. Despite his evident talent and potential to excel beyond high school, Strasburg's performance during his time there didn't garner much attention. In his junior year, he only won one game throughout the season, but improved in his senior year with an ERA under 2 and a fastball velocity in the 90s. Despite his abilities, he didn't receive many notable offers from Division I colleges because of a few different reasons. First, he had a bad habit of getting visibly frustrated with his teammates' errors during high school games and occasionally yelled at them. Another factor that worked against him was concerns about him being overweight. On top of that, when MLB scouts came to watch him play, he would literally tell them not to draft him because he wasn't ready for that level of baseball yet. It became clear that in order for Strasburg to reach his full potential as a player, he needed to address certain maturity issues and improve his physical condition. San Diego State, his hometown college, took a chance on him when most other D1 schools did not. Thanks to pitching coach Rusty Filter's persuasion, head coach and Padres legend Tony Gwynn agreed to give him an opportunity. At this point, the only person stopping Stephen Strasburg from becoming a really good pitcher gaining national attention was Stephen Strasburg. He had a reputation for being lazy, and many of the coaches at San Diego State felt like training him would be a waste of time. He reportedly showed up to campus his freshman year 30 pounds overweight, and couldn't run 4 50-yard sprints without vomiting. The Aztec's strength and conditioning coach gave him the nickname Slothberg, and he even told him to quit the team. Strasburg eventually made the decision that enough was enough, and if he wanted to become the best player he could be, it was up to him. He got his ass in the gym, put himself through rigorous workouts, lost 30 pounds, addressed his maturity issues, and eventually got his fastball velocity to hit 97 miles per hour. In 2007, at age 19, Strasburg served as the team's closer, where he put up some good numbers and showed signs of becoming a very dangerous pitcher in the future. Head coach Tony Gwynn was impressed with his freshman season, so in 2008, he was moved to the starting rotation, and what happens next is something nobody at the time could have possibly predicted. In 13 games as a starting pitcher his sophomore year, he was phenomenal, with stats that included a 1.58 ERA and 133 strikeouts in less than 100 innings pitched. While these numbers cemented his status as one of the country's most promising up-and-coming pitchers, one game stood out among the rest. On April 11, 2008, against Utah University, Strasburg delivered an exceptional performance, pitching a complete game shutout, allowing only one hit, and striking out 23 batters. He concluded the game with the fastball registering at 96 miles per hour for the final strikeout. So just like that, with one incredible season, Stephen Strasburg is a name that people are going to have to get used to hearing. That summer, he received an invitation to join the US national team for the 2008 Summer Olympics in Beijing, making him the only college player in the country to be selected for this honor. He tossed a 7-inning one-hitter versus the Netherlands, followed by 4 innings versus Cuba, where he let up 2 earned runs in USA's 10-2 loss. So in 2 games against some of the best international players in the world, he put up a 2.45 ERA and received a bronze medal just 1 month after turning 20 years old. Now, as he entered his junior year at San Diego State, the hype surrounding him was immense. He was selected as an NCAA preseason All-American, but more importantly, since this was his junior year, he became eligible for the MLB draft after the college season concluded. He faced the challenge of proving that his exceptional performance in the past year was not a fluke, but a true reflection of his readiness for the next level. To say that he proved himself would be an understatement, considering his remarkable junior year that saw an improved record, an even lower ERA, and nearly 200 strikeouts in just over 100 innings pitched, including a no-hitter against Air Force where he struck out 17. These outstanding performances over the past 2 years catapulted Strasburg to the top of MLB draft boards, where he was widely regarded as the best young prospect in all of baseball. The 2009 MLB draft arrived, and it came as no surprise to anyone when the Washington Nationals, holding the number one pick, selected the 20-year-old pitching phenom out of San Diego State. Strasburg teamed up with MLB super agent Scott Boras, who helped him land a 4-year, $15.1 million deal with the team, which at the time was the most money ever dished out to a draft prospect. In 2010, the Nationals initially assigned Strasburg to AA, but quickly promoted him to AAA after just 4 starts. Across 9 games started between the two levels, the 21-year-old pitcher had an impressive 7-2 record with a remarkable 1.3 ERA. As he continued to dominate at the higher levels of competition, the hype surrounding him grew exponentially. Still in 2010, following his brief stint in the minors, the Nationals felt like it was time. They called up the highly anticipated 21-year-old prospect to make his MLB debut against the Pittsburgh Pirates, an MLB debut that will forever be etched in baseball history as one of the best ever. In this game, he threw 7 innings, allowing only 2 runs and 4 hits, and struck out a whopping 14 batters in the Nationals' 5-2 victory. This debut shocked the baseball world, leaving no doubt that Stephen Strasburg had potential to be one of the game's best players. These were his rookie year stats in Washington, a rookie year that was cut short in mid-August after the Nationals received devastating news. It was announced that he had a torn ligament in his pitching elbow, which required the infamous Tommy John surgery in order to get him back to 100%. This caused him to miss the final month and a half of his rookie year and a significant portion of the 2011 season. However, during the limited appearances in 2011, he put up impressive numbers during the small sample size of 24 innings pitched. The focus shifted to the highly anticipated 2012 season, where he was expected to be fully recovered by opening day, providing fans with the opportunity to witness a healthy Stephen Strasburg over the course of a full season. Once again, he did not disappoint, and solidified himself as an MLB star. The 23-year-old had impressive numbers, as he nearly struck out 200 batters and made his first career All-Star appearance. Strasburg and 19-year-old Rookie of the Year Bryce Harper led the Nationals to a 98-64 record, the best in baseball. This sent them to the postseason for the first time in the franchise's short history, where they got bounced in the first round. But the future was bright, not only for Strasburg, but the team as a whole. From 2013 to 2015, Strasburg's reputation as an elite pitcher continued to grow, with all 3 seasons being highly productive. However, despite a top 10 finish in NL Cy Young voting in 2014, he did not make an All-Star team during this period. In 2014, the Nationals as a team had success once again, winning the NL East, but again losing in the NLDS. In 2015, the injury bug bit him again multiple times, after suffering injuries to his ankle, back, neck, and shoulder throughout the year. But once again, Strasburg overcame these obstacles, focused on getting back to 100%, and came out the next year better than ever. 2016 saw him in his second career All-Star game, putting up similar numbers to the 3 years prior where he wasn't an All-Star. Since he was a soon-to-be free agent, Washington wanted to lock up the former number one pick. In May 2016, both parties agreed to a 7-year, $175 million contract extension, ensuring Strasburg's continued presence as a member of the Nationals. Washington won the division again that year, but again lost in the NLDS. Now it was time for 2017, arguably the best season of his career, as he put up the exact same record with a career-best 2.52 ERA, he made his 3rd career All-Star Game appearance and had a 3rd place finish in National League Cy Young voting behind teammate Max Scherzer and Dodgers legend Clayton Kershaw, while for the 4th time in the franchise's history, the Nationals won the NL East and then lost in the NLDS. 2018 proved to be another challenging year for him, as his numbers experienced a slight decline. He also earned the reputation for being injury-prone, as he was dealing with shoulder inflammation and cervical nerve impingement throughout the season, resulting in significantly fewer innings pitched. But once again, this man proved his injuries to be nothing more than a minor setback. When he became fully healthy for the 2019 season, he was once again one of the best pitchers in the game, leading the National League in wins with 18, and striking out 251 batters while earning a top 5 finish in NL Cy Young voting. An 8-game winning streak to end the regular season propelled the Nationals atop the wildcard standings, meaning for the first time in the franchise's history, not only will they play in a wildcard game, but also host one as well, with the 89 and 73 Milwaukee Brewers being the only thing between them and another NLDS appearance. Max Scherzer got the start in this wildcard game where he pitched 5 innings. Down 3-1 heading into the 6th, the Nats put Strasburg in the game out of the bullpen. He pitched 3 scoreless innings to keep his team in the ballgame, and thanks to a clutch hit from Juan Soto and costly error from Trent Grisham, the Nationals rallied to win the game 4-3, giving Strasburg the win. Now it was time to head to Los Angeles to face the 106-win Los Angeles Dodgers in a true David vs. Goliath matchup. Down 0-1 in the series against this powerhouse, Strasburg got the start and he got the win, pitching 6 innings, letting up only 1 run and striking out 10, with the series heading back to Washington. After the team split games 3 and 4, it was time for a series deciding game 5, where Strasburg took the mound again in the biggest game of the season. In this crucial elimination game, he once again pitched 6 innings, this time letting up 3 runs while striking out 7, as the Nationals pulled off the massive upset to eliminate the Dodgers and finally advance to the NLCS. In this best of 7 series versus the Cardinals, he was the starter in game 3, with Washington already up in the series 2-0. He dominated the St. Louis lineup, tossing 7 innings with 0 earned runs and 12 strikeouts, giving his team the 8-1 win and 3-0 series lead. The Nationals, as well as Strasburg, were hotter than ever. The Nats won Game 4, sweeping the Cards, while advancing to the franchise's first ever World Series, where they would take on another powerhouse in the 107-win Houston Astros. After winning Game 1 in Houston, he was back on the mound for Game 2, where he got the win once again, making him 4-0 this postseason run as the Nats took a surprising 2-0 lead in the series as they headed back to Washington. But Houston wasn't going to go down that easy. They won the next 3 games 4-1, 8-1, and 7-1, and went back to Houston up 3-2, meaning in Game 6 of the series, again the most important game of the year, yours truly graced the mound and pitched the game of his life, nearly going the distance while only letting up 2 earned runs as the Nationals forced a Game 7. Strasburg finished this 2019 postseason with a 5-0 record, a 1.98 ERA, and 47 strikeouts in just over 36 innings pitched. But for Game 7, all he could do was watch from the dugout. As you may already know, the Nationals completed this unbelievable, unlikely, and straight-up miraculous postseason run with a Game 7 win, making them World Series champions for the first time ever. Strasburg's contribution during this series did not go unnoticed, as he was named the 2019 World Series MVP. This moment right here was peak Stephen Strasburg. From people doubting him in high school, to college coaches giving up on him, to the pressure he dealt with as a kid in the big leagues, to the countless injuries he's had to overcome, it was all worth it in this moment. He's a World Series champion, World Series MVP, and cemented himself as a postseason legend. Following this season, he returned to Washington for 7 years while getting paid a record-breaking $245 million. The year of 2019 for Stephen Strasburg was one of the best years a human being could possibly have. It couldn't possibly get better, and it didn't, because soon after signing this deal, everything fell apart. In the entire 2020 season, which was only 60 games, Strasburg pitched in 5 innings before he was diagnosed with carpal tunnel in his right wrist that required surgery and shut him down for the rest of the year. He came back in 2021, where he suffered another shoulder injury, then had issues once again with his neck. It was revealed that he had suffered thoracic outlet syndrome, where nerves between your collarbone and ribs are compressed, causing pain and numbness. The string of injuries caused Strasburg once again to miss most of the year, as he only pitched in 21 and two-thirds innings. In 2022, he needed surgery for the thoracic outlet syndrome that season, which again caused him to miss pretty much the entire year, as he only pitched 4 2/3 innings. Lastly, in 2023, it was revealed that Strasburg has severe nerve damage because of this syndrome, which has prevented him from doing any rehab in the past couple months. After failing to make his 2023 debut, the Nationals placed him on the 60-day IL, and we don't know if we'll ever see this man pitch again. This means that since signing his massive 7-year, $245 million deal after the 2019 season, he's pitched in 31 1/3 innings. In other words, he made roughly $2.6 million per out recorded in the last 3 years. Because of these injuries that have kept him off the field, he is considered by many to be the most overpaid player in the league, while the Nationals are accused of dishing out the worst contract in baseball history. And with that, the question remains, how will Stephen Strasburg be remembered? He was one of the most hyped up prospects of all time, once the face of the franchise and a proven all-star. During his highs, he proved to be a generational talent, postseason legend, and an all-time Washington National. During his lows, he was an overpaid, injury-prone, washed-up has-been, that has completely robbed the team that drafted him of $245 million. Yet, at the same time, he showed great resilience bouncing back from the injuries he had earlier in his career, until it just became too much for his body to handle. So there really is no wrong answer when it comes to what you think of him. There's an argument to be made for each claim. Regardless of what you think of him, as we sit here in 2023, it appears that we can officially say we saw the rise and fall of Stephen Strasburg. That wraps up this video. Like I said, I'm going to be making MLB content like this all season long, so subscribe to the channel if you want to see more. Like this video if you enjoyed, thank you for watching, and as always, I'll see you guys in the next one.